Good afternoon. Almost good evening now. This is an important session in the whole context of globalization. Globalization was, in fact, a very popular subject almost, I think, 10-12 years back when it was a everyday talk, even earlier, little earlier. After England decided to come out of European Union, the first de-globalization symptom set into the whole world. People started thinking, is it necessary to get globalized for survival of industry, culture, languages, international relations? In all these subjects, it was felt that there is a need to rethink the whole issue of globalization. Though this globalization process has started almost 10-15 years back aggressively, many people have retained their own original strengths and little of shielding themselves from what is happening all over the world, but still having a good relation with the world. India particularly is one of them. With lot of globalization, we have still kept our identities in several fields. We are open, but still we are very specific in our choice, in our culture, in our languages. With so much of globalization, our religious beliefs, our language beliefs, our cultural beliefs have still remained to a large extent, though they have been polished, open to discussion all over the world, because India was never new to the globalization. Right from the inception, we have always said that the aim of Indian culture is to vasudhaiva kutumbakam. We have always seen that the whole universe is like a family. We live with individuality, but still with brotherhood all over the world. We have never taught anybody wars. India has never gone on wars outside the country. We have fought a lot of wars in the past, in the country itself. But as a country, we have not gone on wars as it happened from Middle East or from West and presently from China. We have not gone anywhere taking our armies and conquering. We have always been telling love, affection, and universal brotherhood. One person known to most of us, one great personality which went global, was Bhagwan Buddha. And after that, it was Vivekananda. And recently, it was Mahatma Gandhi. Under this perspective, we have to think our industry, globalization, at the same time, the values attached to our industrial approach. I think people will have several opinions of themselves and of their organizations. When they are put on such stages, there are chances that people analyze, think, and fresh ideas ultimately will conglomerate here, and new ideas, one of the organizers was telling us that all the things put up here will be published in different websites and regular presentations in their magazines. So by such actions, we can come to some reasonable, because nothing is perfect. It is a reasonable conclusion for the present time. Nothing is eternal. Only few eternal things are there, other than that the industry approach and globalization and presently deglobalization are the issues which should lead, guide this country for the present time. With this, I request my other colleagues here, because a person who presides over the function is the best person who speaks the minimum and gives chances for the learned people to do so. So we have Arunachalam Karthikeyan and Kanak Sabhapati. Both are very highly learned people in their own field of activities. So speeches by learned academicians plus experience of industries will bring new ideas and give a new light to the future industries of this country. I request Sri Arunachalam Karthikeyan to take the present issue. He is a consultant and he is experienced in manufacturing, as already been introduced to. I request Arunachalam to take over the stage. Thank you.